can say. All of us will agree that fake news is a deliberately, you can say, planted news information that is meant to create sensation, immediate sensation in the society. We have gone through the times when hoaxes, rumors were that time, probably created by some mysterious persons, the child getting bored on media, especially on social media, just to create some sensation. But now things have changed. It has come to a dangerous proportion now, and we all see the impact of these news, these narratives on us, on our economy, on our society, definitely on the youth, as well as on the adults. It creates lot of impact. Let's see how things moving in this direction and what is the genesis. In fact, as you all are aware that year 2017, the word fake news was the word for this particular year. There are not many, so many fake news, so many narratives in this, that the whole year was declared as the year for fake news. The genesis, the growth, as we all know that earlier, there was a time when the information dissemination was very difficult, very expensive. So it was very simple. The role of media, the definition of news, it was plain and simple. And people were really skeptical for that. With the advent of internet, with the advent of social media, things move fast. We all know that. The information communication technology, the pace at which it is working, it's really mind-boggling. We all know that. And with that, the things changed. The hoax, the rumor, the small funny games, they all changed the complete paradigm now. It is, we can say that this social media platforms, the Facebook, the Twitter, even the YouTube, our WhatsApp, all they have allowed the people to exchange the information in a very dangerously proportions. There are the websites, the workplace sites, which allow very easy formation of fake websites even. Formation of these websites, exchange of information, the advancement of the technology, all this is fake a long way and in a both positive as well as a negative way to communicate, to express the information, use and misuse of this information in the form of fake narratives. So that means the barriers of creating the fake news have been undone. The latest example is the 2016 elections in US and the effect or the impact of Russia on it. Even in India, more than 31 persons were killed in more than 10 states in 1 year itself. The use of WhatsApp, you can say, use or misuse of WhatsApp. So we all know that this fake news are affecting not only the nations, but our international relations also. Let's have some genesis. Let's have, how does it affect, like, who are the main players, who are the actors, and what are their motives in creating this? I have just tried to categorize this thing. All of us are aware. First and foremost is the commercially driven statements. What for that? They don't have any grounding. They don't have any ideologically driven statements. They are simply for gaining the, you can say, gaining the web traffic and in turn increasing their revenue. Most of our websites popping up during our any conversation is the result of that. Second and foremost is the nation, the state sponsored misinformation. Mind it, they are not for revenue, they are for influence. For influencing the like-minded people. In the gasp of information, in the gasp of any socialized news, these fake news also take turns. So that is the second most. Third and foremost is the highly biased the news sites. We have many news sites which don't have any, you can say, any ideology. They are negatively following one or other particular party, one or other particular field. And they are advising this thing, creating these. Apart from that, the social media itself, whether it is doctor tweets, whether it is YouTube stories, or you can say on Russia, on this thing, it is their video on YouTube. So you see terrorists attacking each other. These are all fake. So social media links, not only the links, but social media itself is creating these narratives, these news, rather this misinformation, which is largely affecting us, our youth, and the whole community as a whole. Apart from that, the light-hearted satires, the parody, which we all know, which were there earlier times also, are playing major roles in this, you can say, in the society of the world. Now the question is, what can we do about these fake news? It is for the sure that the fake news in the society needs to be vaccinated. We need to be removed. But how and when? What are the things? Some things have been told by our earlier speakers also, the technology, the community, the regulation, the legal aspects. Let's see how this is. A survey was done in UK recently. What are the, on some group of young adults, I'll not name the study paper, but it has been done very recently. So it has found that 74% of those youth, the study material, they read news almost on daily basis. 74% read news on daily basis, and they really heavily depend on the digital platform for reading the news. Hardly 4% rely on TV, 1% rely on radio, and almost 0% rely on the print media. I am talking about a study done in UK on the youth, about their study pattern, about their understanding of the news. So, almost 95% of those youth were relying on the digital platforms. And surely the digital platform was divided in mixed balance, 50% on the channels, the digital media, and 50% on the social media. So you can see the effect of the social media, the websites, the news websites on the mind of our generation in understanding those news, in taking information in their minds. And majority of those youths find that the information sources are the trusted. And this trend is gaining popularity in India also. Our youths are also very much interested in news. Not the fake news, not the sensational news, but in the actual things happening. And the pattern is somewhat not only in the major cities, but in the tier 2, tier 3 cities also, in the rural places also. People want to understand how, when, why it is happening. What is the genesis, what is the back end. And for that, they are relying only on the trusted news sources, as well as, you can say, on the more it is trusted. If you start reading a news once, twice, and more number of times, you will start trusting. And definitely, the repetition of the source of the news is the major single factor which affects our mind. If we know that this source of information, this news is from this particular source, we will try to relate with that and we will try to estimate. We will try to start trusting that, okay, this news is from this particular source, definitely it has to be genuine, it has to be true. So the source is one of the very important factors. And mind it, we people, although we believe that social media is not a main source of news outlet, but because of our convenience, because of our lethargy, and because of the ease of getting this news on social media, and the time frame, almost on you can say it's on the real time basis. We start believing whatever news is coming from these social media sites. We start believing that they are genuine, they are true, in true sense. So now this highlights the question whether social media companies should bear the responsibility of monitoring for verification of any news. Who has this responsibility? We as a leader, government, state, or these agencies who are promoting these news. Definitely it has to be a combined effort, but the onus is shifting towards these social media companies, these big groups, by and large throughout the globe, throughout the nations. But up to what extent? Let's see the example of Germany. All of us are aware, last year in June 2017, Germany has come up with a new law, which is called the Network Enforcement Law, NETZ, DG. What it says? It has been effective from 1st of January this year. What it says, that any big social media company, any platform, if divulging any information, any fake news, anything, it has to delete those posts within 24 hours. If not done, a fine of almost 57 million euros will be imposed. And as per the 22 Criminal Rules of Act, insult to the public office or information or articles leading to violence comes under this category. Now this is very surprising. There is a debate going on everywhere. This is good, not good, this is bad. There is advocacy against this, as well as there are factors, there are companies. In fact, the countries like Russia, Philippines, Singapore, they are going in this direction only, in the direction of Germany. They are putting same laws in this, in their countries also. But other countries are again fighting, thinking whether it should be applicable in their places or not. And definitely in India also we need some data protection laws. It should be with the discussion of all the stakeholders after full deliberation, but we really need some protection laws in our country also. If not like Germany, but some mild version we are requiring. But what the technology companies are doing for this? Let's see what is happening. These technology firms like Facebook, Twitter, they have already signed the pacts. They have already signed the pacts. With whom? With these fact-finding websites. Based on some algorithms, some crowdsourcing, they are removing. They are removing the false news at the source itself. The artificial intelligence, the robotics, they are playing a very important role. Not only because of the fear, not only because of this penalties or the heavy fines, but the society as a whole is moving towards a true society, you can say. They are practicing it. Most of the Facebook, etc. have already launched the partnership with the fast-checking websites. What are their role? They check. They have the algorithms, they have the technologies in place. Definitely, it has to come in time. Apart from that, government also has to come up with some programs, some education awareness, you can say schemes, etc. So that in our country, where the masses, the youths are not only technology driven, but hearsay driven. What if you are saying? You are saying that means it must be true. So, some programs, some awareness camps, etc. has to be imparted in our country also. Apart from the efforts being taken by these technology, by these big platforms for creating awareness. And finally, it should be the digital literacy. My take on this is, we all have to be not only literate, but digitally literate and media literacy. All these factors will really play an important role if we have to curb this menace of fake news, fake narratives in the time to come. I will say that apart from that, ultimately it is the role of the state also, the government also, to bring some new amendments, some new laws for the individuals, for the businesses, for the industry, as well as for these social media companies. If they are not put in hold at this moment, at this social juncture, in the times to come, it will really bring lot of disruption in the society as a whole. So with this I will end my listening, but I wish that today's discussion in the panel for time to come definitely will be thought provoking, as well as will give us some inputs, impetus to work about this particular menace of fake news and its impact on society. Thank you.